Ex-Philippine President Duterte will face a Senate hearing next week into his administration's deadly war on drugs. Duterte's attendance was confirmed by his former National Police Chief, now Senator Ronald De La Rosa. The hearing has been set by the Blue Ribbon Subcommittee on October 28th. De La Rosa dismissed calls for him to file an indefinite leave of absence and inhibit himself from the inquiry. The senator insists he has to confront persons whom he referred to as liars because the public deserves to know the truth. De La Rosa was once the chief implementer of the Duterte administration's anti-narcotics campaign. Former Senator Leila De Lima points out similarities in the alleged reward systems of the Duterte administration's drug war and the so-called Davao Death Squad. De Lima spoke at a joint congressional inquiry in which a former police officer retracted his 2016 testimony linking her to the drug trade. Vivian Gulia has the details.
The alleged reward system for cops who kill drug suspects in the Duterte administration's war on drugs appeared to be similar with the Davao Death Squad reward system, according to former Senator Leila De Lima. De Lima, a former chairperson of the Commission on Human Rights, told the House Quadcom on Tuesday that based on their 2009 investigation at the CHR, police handlers received 5,000 pesos and hitmen were paid 10,000 pesos under the DDS reward system from 1988 to 2000. From 2001 to 2016, the reward per team of handler assassins and informants ranged from 13,000 pesos to 15,000 pesos. These were the periods when former President Rodrigo Duterte served as Davao City Mayor, who De Lima referred to as MRRD. She added that the Nanlaban concept originated from the Davao Death Squad.
After the summary execution of targeted victims, the DDS members would regroup at their safe house and divide the reward. During that time, MRRD sometimes personally gave out the kill orders and the reward money directly to the assassins themselves. A team of one PNP handler and three civilian abanteros was given an average of three targets every month.
De Lima said former DDS hitman Arturo Las Cañas confirmed the Davao Death Squad reward system in an affidavit submitted to the International Criminal Court, including the source of funds.
The DDS logistics and finances came from the Peace and Order, or Intel Fund, of MRRD. This includes weekly gas allowance, monthly cash allowance, and Christmas cash gifts.
Posible po ba na ang ginamit din doon naman sa nationwide na war on drugs ay ang intelligence funds, pero this time ay yung intelligence funds ng Office of the President?
Posible rin na gumamit uli ng Intel Fund, this time from the Office of the President.
As De Lima faced off with the so-called poster boy of the Duterte administration's war on drugs, retired police colonel Jovi Espinido confirmed the testimony of Kerwin Espinosa that they were instructed to talk with each other to ensure that their allegations against De Lima would be consistent. Similar to Espinosa, Espinido retracted on Tuesday his 2016 testimony before the Senate implicating De Lima in the illegal drug trade in Bilibid.
There's also a testimony coming from Kerwin Espinosa that you and him were instructed to talk with each other to make sure that your testimonies against Senator De Lima is consistent. Do you confirm this?
I confirm.
Are you retracting all the testimonies that you gave against Senator De Lima during that Senate investigation?
Yes, Your Honor.
There was no face-to-face meeting, however, between De Lima and former President Duterte, who skipped Tuesday's Quadcom hearing. Lawmakers criticized Duterte's absence.
Ang daming sinasabi kapag hindi under oath o wala sa tamang lugar. Pero kapag pinatawag na sa formal na pagdinig, nag-uugaling pusit na pareho. At ang dami ng rason para huwag dumalo.
Non-appearance of former President Rodrigo Duterte at the Quadcom hearing today is a clear manifestation of his disregard for truth, justice, and accountability.
In a letter read during the Tuesday hearing, Duterte's counsel said his client was not feeling well and needed rest, but is willing to appear before the Quad Com on some other date, preferably after November 1st. The chairpersons leading the Quad Com debated on whether courtesy should be given to the former president, who did not submit a medical certificate to justify his absence.
There is no an authority coming from the former president that he will be represented by Attorney Martin V. Delga. And at the same time, no medical certificate confirming that indeed the former president will be excused in today's hearing because of his medical situation.
As we all know, the former president is already old and has been experiencing, based on media reports, has been sick lately and has actually had his medical checkup, I believe. And I think in deference to the former president, I think we should afford him the courtesy that is due to him by not requiring him to submit to this committee a medical certificate.
While the Philippines is no longer a member of the International Criminal Court, De Lima said the country has a law allowing Philippine authorities to give way to investigations conducted by an appropriate international court for crimes against humanity, including extrajudicial killings. She said the country may surrender or extradite accused persons to the said court, but the decision is discretionary on Filipino authorities. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Vice President Sara Duterte firing back at critics who have questioned her state of mind. If you remember, the vice president held a press conference on Friday only to express her dissatisfaction with President Marcos's leadership, and that led to calls for her to seek psychological help. Duterte says she is ready to take on the challenge with one condition. Her critics, including the so-called young guns in the House of Representatives, should undergo the same.
Game tayo. I will call that neuropsychiatric exam. Pero, let us make this an election issue. Ang problema kasi ngayon sa mga politiko, they have never seen a politician who has nothing to lose. They have never seen a politician na IDGAF. As I said, I am nothing of unstable, unbecoming, unsound mind. I'm just unforgiving, unyielding, and unbowed.
Duterte also took aim at Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, accusing him of being ignorant of the law. The DOJ earlier said it is studying legal action against the vice president for her controversial threats to desecrate the remains of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
Ipagdasal natin ang Pilipinas dahil we have a Secretary of Justice na hindi alam ang batas. There is a big difference between talking about desecration a body and actually desecrating a body. Talking about desecration of a body is not desecration of the dead.
President Marcos, for his part, has remained silent on Duterte's attacks against him. The Philippine Military Academy says it had reprimanded the candidate who asked President Marcos Jr. for his wristwatch as a graduation gift. Here's the context. The incident came to light after Vice President Sara Duterte disclosed that Marcos Jr. denied the cadet's request. An armed forces spokesperson did not say when the incident happened, but insists it was already considered a closed book. The spokesperson also clarified the cadet's request for president's wristwatch is not a military tradition.
was that occurred since May po, ano, ng graduation. So it was already dealt with according to regulations of the Armed Forces of the Philippines and the Philippine Military Academy. When it was known by the PMA admin that nangyari yung ganong insidente, he was already admonished for it. Way back.
Security measures for areas at high risk of election-related violence are discussed by Philippine President Marcos Jr. with Interior Secretary John Vicrimulya. There are 38 areas considered as hotspots in next year's midterm elections. 27 of these are the Bangsamoro region. Vicrimulya says he will have further meetings with the president to ensure these hotspots will have safe and fair elections.
Yung iba naman na natitirang hotspots, asaran lang naman yun eh. Hindi pa masyadong, except for, I think, 4th and 3rd district of Leyte, where Albuera is, where doon medyo nagkakaroon na ng mga casualties. So, ayun, we will watch closely kung ano nangyari doon.
The Philippine Election Commission is ordered by the High Court to suspend moves to nullify the candidacies of dismissed public officials. The Supreme Court issued a temporary restraining order on the Commission's resolution to disqualify candidates who have pending appeals with the Ombudsman. The Court acted on the consolidated petitions filed by three dismissed officials, former Albay Governor Noel Rosal, former Cebu City Mayor Michael Rama, and former Mandaue City Mayor Jonas Cortez.